estimates on our assumptions. Okay, so there are three assumptions. Okay, the first one is the sample observation are independent. Okay, and second one is the parent population from which the sample is drawn is normal. Okay, that is population should be normal distributed. Okay, the population should be normal distributed. And third one is various treatment and environmental effect are additive in nature. Okay, so these three are the assumptions of ANOVA. Okay, only when the data satisfies this above three assumption, the result of ANOVA will be valid. Okay, so first we want to check whether the data will satisfy these three assumptions. Okay, so if the data satisfy these three assumptions, then the result of ANOVA will be valid. Okay, that is, the result of ANOVA will be good. Okay, so first step is we want to check whether the data is satisfying these three assumptions. Okay, the first one is the sample observation are independent. Second one is the parent population from which the sample is drawn is normal. And the third one is various treatment and environmental effect are additive in nature. Okay, so these three are the basic assumption of ANOVA. ANOVA types, okay. So there are many types of ANOVA. Here we will see only two types, okay. The one is one-way ANOVA. Okay, one-way ANOVA means if we apply the ANOVA to the one-way classified data. Okay, so data we can classify either one-way, two-way or three-way, okay. So if we apply the ANOVA to the one-way classified data, then it is called one-way ANOVA. Okay, and it's two-way ANOVA. Two-way ANOVA means application of ANOVA to the two-way classified data. Okay, so if you are applying the ANOVA technique to the two-way classified data, then it is called two-way ANOVA. Okay, one-way classification. See, suppose in the data set of n observation, okay, YAG, okay, are classified into K classes. Okay, that is, in the data set we are classifying based on only single factor. Okay, so in one-way classification we are classifying based on only single factor. Okay, that is, we are classifying into k classes of size n1, n2, nk. Okay, such that summation of I is equal to k up to ni is n. Okay, so this is the one-way classification. Okay, so here we are classifying based on only single factor, that is class. Okay, 1 2 3 4 up to k classes. Okay, so this is the one-way classification of data. Okay, so we'll see some example. See, for example, in a problem I want to compare the effect of three different level of fertilizer, that is urea 20 kg and 30 kg and 40 kg. Okay, on application on yield of rice plant. Okay, so in this I'm classifying the sample observation. Okay, sample observation is yield. Okay, the yield of plant is my sample observation. So I'm classifying this data into three classes. Okay, that is based on only single factor. Okay, so here we are having only single factor, that is fertilizer. So the fertilizer the class, we are having three classes. Okay, the first one is 20 kg, and second one is 30 kg. Okay, and third one is 40 kg. So we are classifying the data based on only single factor. Okay, so the factor is fertilizer. Okay, on three classes. Okay, so this is an example of one-way classification data. Okay, so in this data, there will be variation. Okay, the total variation can be seen in two parts. Okay, the first one is the variation between classes. Okay, the variation between classes. Okay, so that is called treatment variation. Variation between classes is called treatment variation. Okay, because we are comparing the three treatment, that is three classes. Okay, so there is variation between classes, and the variation within classes, see here, okay, that is the variation within class. Okay, so the within class is called within treatment variation, that is error variation. Okay, see, for example, for a plant we are giving same kg of fertilizer, okay, 20 kg of fertilizer to all the plants, but the yield is different. Okay, 22 21 and 26 and 21. Okay, so this variation is called error variation, that is due to environment. Okay, the variation within treatment is due to environment. Okay, so we are calling that as error variation. Okay, so variation between classes, treatment variation, and the variation within classes, the error variation. Okay, so here we are concerned with only the variation between classes. That is, we want to find whether there is treatment variation is there or not. Okay, so this classification is similar to like this. Okay, so one way classification data, and here is the example. Okay, so for this data, if we apply ANOVA, see here we are having 3 means. Okay, so we to compare the 3 means, we will apply ANOVA. Okay, so if you apply the ANOVA to this classified this type of data, then it is called one way ANOVA. Okay, so if we apply the ANOVA to this type of data, then it is called one way ANOVA.